Yo, what's up? This is St. Joe, soundsandgear.com. Today I'm checking out the iRig Pro Duo from IK Multimedia. It's a mobile audio interface for Mac, PC, iOS, and Android. So let's check it out. All right, so here's the iRig Pro Duo and the cables you get with it. You get two MIDI cables, then you get your lightning cable. You get your micro USB, and then you get your regular USB cable. So let's take a look at the iRig Pro Duo itself. Of course, you get your gain knobs right here, and your meters, your inputs on the front. Actually, let's pull this up closer. So there's your XLR quarter-inch combo jacks right there on the bottom. If you come to the other side, you got your phantom power on and off, then your quarter-inch outputs with the level. You got your power adapter, your iRig adapter, and your MIDI in and out ports. Then on this side, you got your direct monitor switch as well as your headphone jack with the level. So let's hook this up to the iPad and see what we get. All right, so I got it hooked up. I got my analog 4 going to the inputs. I have my output going to my interface so I can monitor it. Got a 30-pin cable connecting it to my iPad. It does not come with a 30-pin cable, so if you have an older iOS device like myself, you'll either need to purchase the 30-pin cable, or if you have other iRig accessories, you can confiscate one from there. I had one laying around in my drawer. So I just have it going directly into GarageBand. I have direct monitor turned off. I'm just monitoring through GarageBand. There's my input. If you want to hear the difference. So about halfway, and then on the interface, blue just means it's on, green and orange means you're at a safe level. Red, of course, means clipping. So about halfway for this. I have it set to stereo, so I'm good. And I figure the best way to test this out is to record some stuff. So let's just see what we get. Just want to do 4 bars, so let's go over here and look at it. Looks like we have a nice little wave. Change this really quick. And let's see what it sounds like. So it seems like a nice clean input. Let's just try to throw some more stuff. I'll throw another audio track in there. Again, I want it to be stereo. I want to turn monitor on. Let's try something to see. I'm just going to play and kind of audition. That kind of sounds good. I'll probably go in and adjust the levels a little bit, but just messing around. That wasn't the note I wanted. See, got that in there. Let's see what it sounds like. All right, that's cool. Let's do I got monitor turned off. So, and I actually when I was using this earlier, I was like, man, I wish we could turn direct monitor off. And then I looked over to the side and saw it there. So really cool that they included that. Let's do another one. We'll just do stereo. And I want to monitor. Let's mess around with some stuff and see. I don't know. We'll do something. We'll figure out something. Well, let's see what we got. A little bass or lead. And it sounds like I'm getting exactly what I'm putting in, which I like. It doesn't sound like it's changing it. It seems like it's recording it exactly as I want. So I don't know. Let's throw some drums on this thing. See if we can do. GarageBand doesn't really have a nice selection of drums. I would probably use something different, but. But you get the idea. So just throw something over it. So we got that. What I want to do now, let's hook up a mic and record some live percussion and see how it works with the mic. We already tried the audio input, so why not try a microphone? I'm going to just use a dynamic mic and let me get that hooked up and then I'll be back. All right, so now I got my SM57 hooked up to the input. So let's see if we can just capture some percussion, see if we get some good levels and everything like that. I just want to use a dynamic mic just to see what type of gain I can get just from the interface itself. So let's see what we get. Let's see what that sounds like. Sounds good. So let's see. Got a good level. So I don't know. Maybe I just got my percussion over here. So maybe we'll try something with that. Let's just throw another track in there. So man, it sounds pretty good. Just grab up some percussion. Let's do maybe we'll throw something like this in here. So I'll just pull up another audio track. See what that sounds like. They would throw a vocal in there, like some type of random yeah or something like that, and throw some effects on it. Let's see. I don't know. We'll mess around with something. Let me get the mic situated. Yep. 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 All right. So let's see if we can record a vocal, say something like yep or something like that, and then I'll probably throw some effects on it really quick. Yep. Try to use it in a practical way, record some line level stuff, record some mic input, and I found that the noise level is really good. Like, unless you turn it all the way up, I really didn't hear any noise, even with the mics. When I turned it all the way up, I got some room noise and different things like that, but if I backed it off just a little bit, it was clean again. So really clean inputs. What you put in is what you get out, from what I'm seeing, and I really dig that. So overall, I'm gonna give it a 4.5 out of 5 subs. Great product, very portable and universal. It works with your Mac, PC, iOS, and it works with Android. So, you know, definitely something that you can just grab and go. Battery life, the batteries that came with this didn't last too long, but, you know, those are usually not the best batteries you get in the box. That's just something to get you started. If you throw some higher end batteries in there, you probably get longer life. I got probably like an hour, a little bit over an hour with the ones that came with it. But like I said, you can just throw some other ones in there. No need to worry about powered USB hubs or power adapters, anything like that. So really makes it flexible. I do wish the finish was a little bit more of a matte finish, kind of like the other iRig stuff. That's just a personal preference. I'm not, you know, particularly fond of this shiny input right there. But overall, man, again, really nice quality. It does have MIDI input and output as well, so you got all your connections, and I'm glad that they finally made a stereo device. So let me know what you think. Like, comment, subscribe to the channel if you haven't. Again, this is St. Joe, soundsandgear.com, checking out the iRig Pro Duo. 4.5 out of 5 subs. Let me know what you think. You can get this from IK Multimedia's website for $199. I'll see y'all later. Peace.